So this thing is what? Luck. Another puzzle. So, remember those shapes from the memory game? Yeah, this is why you have to take count of how many there are, because if you move the dice, it'll count a number for how many times you've seen it. And if you see a teddy bear hanging here, remember that image from the Hall of Records that I said was important? This plays a part right here. So let's see how many times Hoburg was there. I counted 8 times that I saw him, so let's move the dice to 8. The skull, I saw twice. And the mulberry bush, I saw 4 times. So if you click that, and if you counted right, then you get the chime. There's the big robot. Except that's all right. What is that all about? Okay, well, we're done here, so let's go back. Take me back, man. Take me back to when rock and roll was hot. Oh wait, this isn't a time machine. Rock and roll's still hot. Let's put this bottom one here. I think that one takes us back to that basement room. Yeah. I'm gonna go back to where we were. Let's put this red one here. Damn it. Wrong guess again. Green one. That's the one I wanted. So, we saw a big robot, and we saw the teddy bear, and the Hall of Records also showed a cannon blowing up a giant robot that looked very similar to that one, so let's head back that way. This is why we didn't pull the string earlier. Takes you all the way back down. So you'd have to go through the whole process of shrinkifying and then getting back up there. It's an inconvenience, but anyway, that's what that does. Keep walking. It's fun. For anything, just enjoy the tunage. Alright, so we're locked in. You activate the radio again, and then turn it all the way back. You can see the light shut up in the corner there, and the door opens. That one's not an obvious one. This is how you actually get out of here, if you don't notice that the door closes in the first place. Back up the stairs. So, before we actually get in the cannon, there's going to be one thing we want to do first. And that's going to be the last time that we have to mess with this staircase here. Such an ingenious operation. The wonders of clay. Walk all the way out. So if we remember back to when we were in the Weasel's lair and riding that claw machine and there was that track that ended just abruptly, well, it's very, very important that you remember that that's there now, because when we pulled that pin out, the worlds collided and, well, you know, very, very important. The weasel is no more. Let's turn down through here. Take me for a ride. Convenience. Yes. I love it. There's this dark tunnel taking me. It's the tunnel of love. Go. Go. Hey, this place looks familiar. Now get out. This thing up. We're gonna need that. Or what adventure game can you find shit? Look out the window. Can you find shit that you actually don't need? I mean, there are adventure games where, yeah, they put useless items in there to confuse you, but I think that's just plain mean. It's creative thinking, but it kinda sucks. Get out of here. Leave. I will side with the point that it does make the game a lot harder to figure out, is if there's items that are there just to throw you off track. Like, Shadowgate and Uninvited are the ones that come to mind most prominently for being games where there's crap you don't ever use. Fallout 3 is kind of another one, or any of the Fallout games for that matter. You don't need everything you pick up. It's just there for stuff. Okay. Well, that's all we can do over there. Let's head back to the cannon. Because that's what Picture on the Wall told us to do. Do-do-do-do-do-do. It's like Town Square. This goofy looking tree. Anyway, getting caught up by the scenery. Which looks really pixelated to me because I'm playing on a huge screen. It'll look different to you. If I hear one person bitching about how this game has bad graphics, like, I don't even want to hear it, because, first of all, this game's, like, almost 15 years old. Second of all, it's fucking clay. It's claymation. It's good just because it's made out of clay. So, there you go. So I don't have to do it in a few minutes. Going to put the bridge back down because we have to go back down there. Lower! To the basement, please. Ding! Back in the cannon. Animation is a little shorter the second time around, so let's put in the first code we found from the Hall of Records. Select one of these. Should be another one of those. And then the three circles and some lines. That's the one. You know you got it right when you get this little arrow here. And then the second one, which is already two-thirds of the way completed. And there you go, that was an easy one. So if you click on each one of these, I think we gotta do the bottom one first, though. It's really high up here. And then click on this one.